Hey, good morning, guys. How are you? Wait a couple of minutes till people start joining. Then we'll turn the camera around. So excited that you guys are here. A lot of great stuff going on. Well, this is going to be a really short one because of I'm just on my lunch break right now from the seminar. Hey, Linda, how are you? I miss you. Thanks for all the great photos. Hey guys, hey, how are you? If you're just tuning in, if you don't know who I am, if it's your first time here, my name is Jeff Gelman of Solid Canine Training, and I'm a real-world balanced dog trainer based in Providence, Rhode Island, and I'm also involved with a bunch of different seminar series. I'm at the T3 Portland seminar right now, Oregon, and that's Train the Trainers, and we've got a group of 14 folks that are interested in dog training or already are dog training, and it's a six-day seminar, and we work on personal growth, clients, relations, social media, overcoming fear, self-confidence, and then obviously massive amounts of on-leash and off-leash dog training skills. So what it does is it sets people up for massive amounts of success with a blueprint, how to be successful in dog training. All right, hey, Louisiana, how are you? And great, okay. So, I don't know if anybody, if you follow me on Facebook, you'll see the last couple of days, there was a, hey, Wisconsin, how are you? Last couple of days, there was a photo of this Australian Shepherd with a couple. And we work with them one time. We work with them for an hour on either Monday or Tuesday. And then we met them this morning for coffee. And this is a dog with two, a husband and wife, very intelligent owners. They're very in tune with all of the tools. They've fully off-leash trained their dog. They've been working for 2 years. They've done some really intense training. It's a great dog. It knows all kinds of great things. It listens to obedience. Its obedience is fantastic. But some of its behavior is not acceptable and dangerous. What does that look like? Lunging at humans, barking at humans, both on leash and off leash, as well as dogs. So they're big outside people on hikes. I know, Utah, I'm sorry. Yep, I know. I'm a little bit wonky on the time zone thing, but that's why I'm here right now. So the title of this is Address the Small Stuff Strongly and the Big Stuff Will Not Manifest. A lot of people, I will let you know right now, are going to struggle with this. I understand that, and I am super, super respectful of that. Because lunging is different. That's behavior. So there's behavior modification. But I agree with you. How can a dog be well obedient but still lunge? I agree. It lunges when it gets stressed. That's a coping mechanism to that. Got it. Right. So in other words, you can be a really intelligent person, but you still get into fist fights, or you still drive erratically, or you still are mean to your children or to your spouse, or you still litter, or you still break the law. So there's like, we separate obedience and behavior modification, but you're right, there's a little bit of a gray area. Excellent point. If you like this, you can hit a bunch of different hearts by hitting your screen, and that's what gives me hearts. Also, you can share this on Twitter and Facebook by hitting the little unisex character in your little bottom of your screen, and then you could put me on Facebook and Twitter. Hey, cool things, guys. I just got a couple of new lenses for my iPhone I'm going to try out later. So I've got a wide-angle lens, and I've got a fisheye lens. So I got some really cool equipment for my iPhone so I can start really stepping up my Periscope stuff. So I think maybe I'm going to try those later tonight. Maybe tonight I'll try those. How's that? Maybe I'll try my wide angle lens. Why? I don't know. I'll be in my hotel room, so I might not want to do it. But I'm going to give it a shot. All right. So Excuse me. That was disgusting and gross. I apologize. So the photo that I showed this morning, so imagine this. This is what it looked like. The dog's in a down next to the couple. Somebody walks up. The dog lunges at them. Barking and lunging. It's on a leash and they're walking. Somebody drives by or walks by, or a bicycle walks by, or a person or dog walks by. It lunges. That's the behavior modification thing. Now, what most people do is this. Most people then correct their dog once the dog has lunged. So show of hands, most people do that. They wait till the dog has the bad behavior and then they react to that bad behavior. It's very common. It sort of makes sense to do. The first session I had with them was in the hotel parking lot, Sean and I. So Sean O'Shea from The Good Dog, thegooddog.net. You can go check him out. And if you're just tuning in, my name is Jeff Gelman of Solid Canine Training. I travel the world doing seminars, but I'm also an active dog trainer with a training center in Providence, Rhode Island, with an awesome 9-person staff that is just rocking and rolling with dogs on one-on-ones and board and trains. Oh, by the way, we just announced, I know I need water. I know, it's obvious. I just had a sandwich. I know, hold on. Let me take a sip of coffee. I was doing that lip smacking thing, wasn't I? That's so annoying. I know. I'm trying to multitask, eat a sandwich and get onto Periscope. But I mind. But thank you. But I mind. So this is what we did. First session I ever met them. The dog's in the back of their SUV in a crate. We talked to the owners in the parking lot of the hotel. And we were ready to work the dog. The dog's in the back of the crate. I said to them, what does your dog do when you open up the crate? It stays there. Okay. Does your dog have a release command? Yes, it does. Good. I opened up the crate. The dog paused. I stood in front of the crate and I just went, which is not the release command. Let's clarify that. If I would have said break, that would have been the release command. So that would have been mean if I did something. All I said was, the dog started coming out of the crate. I took the crate door, my hand was on the crate door, and I closed it very firmly. Very firmly on the dog. It hit the dog's head. Don't worry, it's a crate. It's no big deal. I've seen dogs smash themselves into crates 10 times harder. Some people are going to struggle with this. All due respect, I understand, and there's other ways that people do this. I understand that, but I'm just telling you, this is how we do it, and we're very successful. The dog immediately went back into the back of the crate and laid down. Did it look afraid? Yes, it did. It did. It actually did look afraid. Great. So then I said to the owners that I opened up the crate, and we left it there. The dog didn't move. Then I told the owners, grab the leash, give it the release command, and start walking the dog. 5 seconds later, the woman, Dawn is her name, she's on my Facebook page, said, oh my gosh, my dog has never walked so focused with me. The crate did that, right? And I'm like, right. I never worked with the dog. I didn't handle the dog at all. There is a direct correlation between addressing the small stuff strongly so the big stuff never happens. Okay. I've done this thousands of times. That's why I'm preaching this stuff. I've done this thousands of times. So then the dog was looking up at her, not constantly, not competition heel, but just checking in with her all the time. She said, my dog has never been so focused on me. Remember, I never handled the dog. These are her words. We had a 1-hour training session. I said, okay, What are the normal triggers of your dog? If my dog's in a down, somebody approaches, the dog lunges at them. Okay, great. The dog is fully remote collar trained. I said, what do you normally correct the dog on if it misbehaves? 15 maybe. The working level is an 8. Okay. Turn it up to 40. If you've never used remote collars before, they can be used low and they can be used high. We train on low, but we correct on high for a known command only. A known command. That means this dog has done this hundreds of times. She's been working on this for 2 years. She's been trying to get her dog for 2 years to break this habit. Been to many trainers. I said, okay, great. So Sean and I were there. So I said, turn it up to 40. I walk up to them like I would do to any other couple. And the dog all of a sudden perked up its ears and moved slightly towards me. We hit continuous really quick. Yes, the dog made audible. Yes, that was a correction. High correction for small infraction to set the tone. Why? Because if we wait till the dog explodes, we've missed the opportunity, the dog isn't listening, and now that it doesn't help. Why? Because everybody is waiting till the dog is doing this. Some people will struggle with this. I understand. You will think it's mean. I understand. But I'm letting people know it works. You can either be chasing your dog constantly, or as Sean O'Shea, my colleague, says, cap the dog, meaning don't do that. Okay, we did this one time. So one slam, one bit of information at a high level that lasted 1 second. There's 64,400 seconds in a day. 1 second. For the next 45 minutes, this dog was a rock star. So then you say to yourself, well, how does it transfer? It's only going to behave when you're around Jeff or Sean's around. I understand that philosophy. I understand that line of thinking. Now, that week, we saw them again today. How's your week been? It has been the most incredible week we've ever had in 2 weeks. What does that look like? The dog is not being reactive. The dog is holding place. The dog is more relaxed. These are the owner's words from a highly intelligent owner that is in tune with her dog. They said, we'll never be able to take this dog to a coffee shop. 2 years they've been working on this. They can't bring the dog to a coffee shop. 2 years. Hold on 1 second, everybody. Okay. This is this morning at a coffee shop. Outside. This is this morning. We had 6 people while we were there. We would say, excuse me, can you just run up to us really quick? Talking really loud. So what we do is we saw people in the parking lot and I would go, hey, how you doing? What's going on? How have you been? I miss you. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I saw you here. And they would come running up. Oh my gosh, it's so good to see you. Hugs, kisses, high fives. The dog didn't move. Now, we could easily say, well, the dog was afraid to move. That sort of makes sense, right? Sure. That's a philosophy. Or we could say the dog has finally felt that it didn't have to do that because the humans now are doing what the dog was doing, which is advocating. The dog felt safe. The dog felt safe. Was the dog nervous? Slightly, yes. Was the dog more relaxed? Definitely, massively. But if you look at a dog that is calm as stressed, you're not going to like anything I have to say anyway. Because the dog is supposed to be calm. For 2 years, they could not take their dog to a coffee shop. We told them Saturday morning, 8 a.m., oh, we're going to a coffee shop. We went to a coffee shop, high level of activity. I'm not saying this to boast or brag or for ego. All I'm saying is address the small stuff. No yelling, no screaming, no bad dog. Well, we're not zapping. Let's not use the word zap because I don't like the word zap, and I'm not trying to manipulate the public because it's more of correct or give information. Because I'm really trying to change the vocabulary that people use so it makes more sense. But no, there's no verbal. There's no verbal. No, don't ever apologize. No. I'm trying to create vocabulary so everybody's on the same page, because I think when we're trying to educate, it's important that everybody's on the same page. We didn't use the remote once that I recall. I don't think we had to. If we did, then we had to, but it's no big deal, but I don't remember doing it. But we absolutely would have if we had to. Address the small things. Address the small things big, and the big things don't manifest. Stop waiting until your dog explodes. It's too late. You've lost it. You've literally turn around and go the other way. Now, this is with a dog who's already understands, no, they won't. Zombie, that's an awesome question. Would the dog ever associate people negatively then in your experience? No, they will not. That has been repeated over and over and over again, that I've seen all over the time, but I have never seen it. My colleague Sean O'Shea has never seen it, and there are a half a dozen balanced trainers that we brainstorm and mastermind with. They have never seen that happen, and we do it. So remember, when somebody does it over and over and over again, that's our own scientific study. We've never seen a dog do that because it's done from an emotional standpoint on our part. Now, that doesn't mean you go around doing high levels for everything at all. They're called fair, calm corrections. Fair, calm corrections. I'm not angry, I'm not mad, I'm not upset, I'm not disappointed in you. It's a matter of fact, sorry, you can't do that right now. Because I need to clear up the clutter in the dog's head. I need to clear. So this morning, I will post more pictures from today. We invited them today for an hour, and they did a group walk with us today. That dog was around 15 dogs and 17 people, and there was no issues whatsoever. I am. Yep. Did you like my movie, The Walking Dead? I am. But business is a little bit slow, so I've gotten into dog training. Okay? All right. You're welcome. You're welcome. So if you like what you hear, give me lots of hearts. Heart by tapping the screen. And then also there's a little character in the corner. You can hit that and you can share me on Facebook. Share me on Twitter. Also, if you're watching the replay, you can swipe and share left to right on your iOS, up and down on your Android, and you also can give me hearts on the replay. So the working level for your lab is 22. It could be. I would make sure that you've got, it's a lab chow. I would maybe use longer prongs and make sure thick fur prongs, and also make sure you've got a really snug fit. An absolutely snug fit. Okay? And what dog trick collar is it? IQ 280 or 1900? Which dog trick collar is it? All right? Which dog trick collar is it? So that's important. Madly in love with you guys. I know you missed this morning. Tomorrow morning I will do a motivational one. Don't worry. I'll do a motivational one tomorrow. Some coffee talk, or maybe I'll do a bedtime one. Maybe we'll do a bedtime one. But I know tonight, Sean and I and Laura need to do, we have got some one-on-one consults. Maybe you guys saw the photos on our Facebook page. And then what we'll do is we do a lot of business building. We do anything from Skype visits to conference calls to live one-on-one. And it's all based on mostly business building. So Sean and I both have our own consulting on the side as well as together, and we do business consulting. We'll help you build your business. What's your goals? What's your dream? What's your life dream? And we'll help you do it. What you're doing. So the collar should be so snug that when you move the box around, it doesn't freely move. It doesn't freely move. All right? It doesn't freely move. So, small stuff for large infractions. I'm telling you, it makes the difference. Everybody's just nagging. The dog explodes, and then it's too late. And then they go hard, but the dog doesn't feel it. Oh, for everybody's information, I just announced last night that we are doing a Dallas seminar as well, Dallas RV. So it's on my Facebook page now. So for all my folks in Dallas, we're doing one. Sean, okay, just to let everybody know, Sean is doing zero junk food. Zero junk food. Sean is doing incredible. He's lost 15 pounds. He sent me a picture of him. I'm not going to share it, but he sent me a picture of him with his shirt off. The man for 47 looks better than people half his age. He's 47 and he looks incredible. Yeah, I'm proud of him. Yep, sugar is extremely addictive. He's doing great. Sean is an incredible inspiration. Sean, are you in there? Sean! He might be out on a run, or maybe he's doing some of his own social media. Maybe I can get him on here to show about the personal growth journey that he does. And all of us work on it every day. Every day. Guys, every day. Yeah, Sean's 47. I'll be 50 in 2 months. I'll try to get him with his shirt off. I'll try to get him with his shirt off because he looks great. Not to show him off, but to show him what 47 can look like. That's all. If anybody cares. If anybody cares. Thank you for early birthday. January 7th. January 7th, I'll be 50. And where will I be? I'm not sure where I'll be. I think I'll be in... No, I'll still be in Rhode Island. I think I'll be... No. I'll be in Florida, I think. Heading to Florida. Virginia. All right. So, I just want to give everybody an update. I really wanted to touch on the point about addressing the small stuff because I know a ton of people struggle. And most of my webinars on Mondays and Wednesdays are for leash reactivity and for dogs exploding. And it's what it is we're waiting till we're waiting till we're past it. We're waiting till it's over. And I want people to address it sooner. I'll be in Philly soon. We've got Philly in the works. We're also going to be announcing Australia soon. And two more Canadian. So we've got two Canada, two Australia. Oh my God, this is your first Periscope? Welcome. I'm based in Providence. Seminar. If it's a seminar question, you can ask me now. But also, who's new? Type in new. Also, do people know how to take photos? Am I doing a webinar today? No, my webinars are Mondays and Wednesdays for my Q&A webinars. Do people know how to take a photo? This is what I want you to do right now. It's a cool thing we can do on Periscope. If you could, what you do is, does everybody know how to do a screenshot? You can take a screenshot of me. This is what I want you to do. Take a screenshot of me and then I want you to tweet it to me. It's at solidcaninetraining.com. Tweet it to me and I'll send you back a personalized video. Ready? So, and I want you to put, I love bananas. Ready? So I see photos coming up. Yep, photos coming up. How do on an Android? I've got no idea how to take a photo on an Android. Good. How to tweet, you have to have a Twitter account and you would just put in send message and you would do @solidcaninetraining. You would attach the picture and you get it to me. Yes, there'll be a T3 in Florida and also there's going to be a T3 Accelerate in New Orleans. You can bring one dog. Android, press the power and menu button at the same time. What? Clementine, are you serious? I'm so sorry. I'm doing like 12 of those every time. Clementine, let me look for you. You tweeted me. I'm going to have to go back, and I'll go back. Clementine, what's your Twitter handle? We're probably going to be doing a T3 in the Ellington-Bradenton area. All right? Ellington-Bradenton area. We'll be announcing those dates very shortly, and then we're doing a T3 Accelerate. We'll be announcing those dates in New Orleans. And yes, Accelerate, you don't bring any dogs. Accelerate is a 2-day business building one, and Launch is a 6-day, it'll actually be a 7-day everything program, and you can bring a dog. Yep. We have dog trainers that bring client dogs with them. Yep, we have dog trainers that bring client dogs with them. The equipment list for T3 goes out usually before, that's a Laura Morgan thing. I have no idea. Laura does all the admin, all the money, all the organizing. She does all the planning. And then Sean and I do the curriculum and we do the teaching. Laura also does a lot of teaching. So today we're working on, we did remote collar healing we did today. And the seminar in Tucson, Arizona, that goes out a week before. But it's also it will also be on the event page in Facebook. Yep, you probably did. Yep, you probably did. So for RV, on every RV seminar has an event page on Facebook, and there's usually a list of what you need, and then there's also hotel suggestions. And if not, we'll work on that some more. You lucky doggo four. All right, I'll keep an eye out for that. Wait till I get back to the hotel tonight, Clementine, and I'm on the West Coast, so I'm not sure where you're located, but right now it's probably like 5 minutes to 2 on the West Coast. So normally I'm on the East Coast, and then next week I'm in Hawaii. I'll be doing periscopes from Hawaii. How cool is that? So this right here will be ocean. This will be ocean instead of beautiful, beautiful greenery. Isn't this beautiful? We're in Battleground, Washington, which is right over the bridge from Portland, Oregon. It's fantastic here. Fantastic here. All right. Make sure you lots of hearts, lots of hearts, lots of hearts. Okay. Heart by hitting your screen. Also share this. Also make sure you follow me. Follow me on all my social media because I put all different content on all my social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Periscope. There's a little bit of crossover, but there's a lot of stuff that's individual and unique. Individual and unique. All right. Okay. Any quick questions before I tune off? Not about your dogs. Not about your dogs because I'm not in, you know, dog training mode. I'm not here for Q&A. All right. Checking dogs out. We got a lot of dogs here. A lot of attendees brought their dogs. Dramatic difference. What I'll do is I'll see if I can set up some interviews tomorrow with, oh my gosh, I'm madly in love with you too. Who's that? Back, BA canine trainer. I'm madly in love with you too. You want to be a sister wife? You could be an RV girlfriend if you want. You can be an RV girlfriend. Oh, Sarah, hey, how are you? And I would say that if my wife was here, I say that in front of her too. She doesn't care. So when Linda sits next to me, she's like, Linda, can I have an RV girlfriend? She's like, I don't care. And if you want to, you're feeding your baby. Awesome. Okay, T3 is called Train the Trainers. You can go to Train the Trainers with SeanandJeff.com. Sean is S-E-A-N. And today, this week, it's a 6-day seminar. Next year, there'll be a 7-day seminar. And it's a combination of personal growth, business development, social media, overcoming fear and anxiety, and then obviously a lot of dog training skills. Oh my gosh, I can't wait to hold your baby. I love babies. Love them. A shadow with me and a T3, you actually want to go to both. So a shadow with me is going to be, or you can shadow Sean, is going to be much, you're welcome, M-Flow, by the way, I'm loving the support. Because I know you were brand new this week, and now I notice that you're on a lot of my stuff. So I want to know that I want to know that M-Flow, I really, really appreciate it. It means a lot to me. It means a lot to me. And there goes Denise, whose life has changed. Denise, I got to get you.
Look at her. She just ran into the cage.
That's good. Denise is great. Is Sean moving to NOLA? Yes, he is. Yes, he's moving there. He's keeping his business in L.A., and he'll be moving to New Orleans. He'll still go back to Los Angeles, but he'll be making, I think, his home base in New Orleans. And if that's not official, now you guys know. So maybe I wasn't supposed to tell you that, but now you know. Denise, come up here.
Down.
Come up here. Nope. Quick. Come and sit next to me over here. Okay, this is Denise, and I'm super proud of her.
Hello. I don't know who we're talking to.
Don't worry about it. So, Denise, tell me about T3.
T3 has been fantastic. I actually, I'm the one that was potentially going to leave on the first day.
Nobody knows that.
Nobody knows that.
Why? Why are we going to leave? Why are we going to leave on the first day?
Because I was so upset about my dog, who's clearly not. It wasn't at the time crate trained very well, and I thought she was hurting herself. So this has been life transforming. I'm realizing that I can make a change in my life. I don't always have to do what's expected, and that my dog is just a dog, and she'll be fine.
Right. And what are you learning here? What's the most important thing you think you've learned? Because everybody thinks it's like, oh, how to train dogs. But what have you learned?
Maybe that I can do what I want to do. I don't have to do necessarily what's expected of me, and I can do what I want to do and make it happen for myself.
Right, right. That's incredible.
Who are we talking to?
You're talking to a bunch of people from around the world on Periscope. That's great. So we're proud of you.
Thank you.
We're so
Thank
proud
you.
Of you. And we'll talk to more T3ers in, you know, We'll get guest appearances, don't worry. But everybody's heading in right now, and I just got a dirty look from Laura Morgan, which means, Jeff, get the F off Periscope and get your ass inside, because we're about to start our curriculum. All right? So lunch break is over. I'm madly in love with you guys. Everybody, one last round of hearts. And also, if you're not following me, follow me on Periscope, because you'll get the instant alerts, and make sure that you hit the notifications on. And I will do another one tonight, because I want to try out my wide-angle lens on Periscope. And I'll try to get another guest appearance. But I know that we've got business consults. A lot of people, whenever Sean and I are together, a lot of people want us to do one-on-one business consulting with them, because we help build people's businesses and we help people live the dream life that they want. It does not have to be about dog training. A lot of our stuff crosses over into a lot of different modalities. All right, madly in love with you guys, and thank you so much for all your wonderful support. And if you miss this, you can always watch the replay. All right, take care, everybody.